Theologists, scientists, and thought leaders have attempted for centuries to understand the impact that religion can have on human beings, both mentally and physically. And it's commonly accepted around the world that religion and spirituality are among the most important of cultural factors, giving structure and meaning to our behaviors, our value systems, and experiences. And there's ample reason to believe that faith in a higher power is associated with health, and in a positive way. So it's surprising in 2019 that there's still little quantitative research published in peer-reviewed journals exploring the relationship between spirituality, religiosity, and health. So we wanted to take a little time and answer some of your questions about religion and health. So stick around and be sure to subscribe, and we will answer all of your questions in the coming weeks. Welcome back. This week, we took some time to answer your questions about religion, spirituality, and health. So be sure to send us more questions so that we can get to those in future weeks. According to the Mayo Clinic, most studies have shown that religious involvement and spirituality are associated with better health outcomes. That includes greater longevity, coping skills, and health-related quality of life, even during terminal illness. Also, less anxiety, depression, and suicide. And several studies have shown that addressing the spiritual needs of patients can actually enhance recovery from illness. Existential questions that can't be answered by medical professionals often accompany seeking medical care. This is particularly true for those with more traumatic or chronic conditions. Thus, when seeking answers to questions like, why me? Or what's the meaning of this? People often look outside traditional health settings, including religion, for answers. It's natural behavior for humans to turn to faith and belief systems when they touch the healthcare system. Now, we just need the care system and the research community to integrate the growing body of knowledge into the patient experience and the continuum of care. A primary reason for the lack of institutional knowledge in this area of study is that as the centuries have progressed, scholars in fields like medicine, public health, sociology, spirituality, religion, economics, law, they've all gone to distinct silos. Subsequently, there is a growing body of research. It just exists in disparate fields with little implication about the overlap. There's also a lot of contention about definitions of terms like religious and spiritual, making it difficult to standardize and impossible to randomize studies. That said, the lack of knowledge linking religious behavior and health is fascinating, given that healthcare is deeply rooted in institutions. In fact, it was religious organizations that built many of the first hospitals, and clergy, offsetting their low wages, were often medical providers. This is true in the Middle East and in the American colonies. And a lot of their work included focus on mental health, with both good and bad outcomes. However, as time passed, the link between religion and healthcare has slowly fallen to the wayside because of strict clinical practices and medical protocols. But given how much we're learning about the influence of social, emotional aspects of life and their impact on health, it's about time that religion and medical communities start to talk. So here are a few things you might find interesting about religion and health. 80% of research on spirituality and religiousness focuses on mental health. It's because most associations with faith are related to how one thinks about the world around them and their role in it. So words like hope, optimism, trust, purpose, all of these things are shown to boost mental health. Now, while mental and physical health are intricately intertwined, the physical manifestations of spirituality and religion are often indirect. What this means is that our belief system drives the way we think and behave, which in turn impacts our health-related actions. For example, people with greater depression and anxiety have more physical health problems. And in turn, worse mental health and physical health lead to a lower quality of health and life expectancy. Caring for one's physical body is emphasized in many faiths. this leads many individuals to actually take better care of their bodies by abstaining from drinking or prioritizing meditation or just not taking part in activities that may have negative consequences on the body. But there's a chasm between doctors and patients. A 2018 survey of American physicians and patients suggests that about 64% of physicians believe in the existence of God or a higher power, and more than 90% of patients claim they do. This is consistent with a Pew study that was conducted and showed 90% of Americans believe in a higher power. In contrast, 25% of physicians said they're uncertain. While many in the medical community may think it therefore inappropriate to ask patients about beliefs and faith, patients actually disagree. One study concluded that 77% of patients thought physicians should consider a patient's spiritual needs. More specifically, 48% welcome their physician to pray with them, and another 37% wanted physicians to discuss religious beliefs with them while making health-related decisions. So no matter where you stand on religion or faith or spirituality, it's clear that what you believe, and even what your physician believes, can have a huge impact on your health. So let's send more questions and keep the conversation going, and let us know what else we can learn with you about religion and health.